This video is to allow you to correct your homework from section 1.1.3. The problems are 119 through 123. So first of all, they want you to study the dot patterns in these two parts. Assume that each pattern continues to increase by the same number of dots in the same locations for each figure. They want you to sketch the fourth and fifth figures, then predict how many dots will be in the 100th figure. So first of all, we got to look for kind of what the pattern is. One thing you might notice here is that we have one dot in the middle in each case. I'm sort of calling that in the middle. And then on figure one, we have one dot above it, one to the right, one below. In figure two, we have two above, two to the right, two below. In figure three, we have three above, three to the right, three below. So based on that pattern, we'd expect figure four would have that one in the middle again, then four above, four to the right, four below, and figure five, again that one, and then five above, five to the right, five below. As far as figure 100 goes, figure 100 should have 301 dots, because it would have the one in the middle, the green, and then it would have 100 above, 100 to the right, 100 below. So 100 plus 100 plus 100 would be 300, plus that one in the middle would be 301. For B, we see that figure 1 has two vertical dots. Figure 2 has two columns of two vertical dots. Figure 3 has three columns of two vertical dots. So figure 4 would have four columns of two vertical dots. Figure 5 would have five columns of two vertical dots. So then figure 100 would have 100 columns of two vertical dots, meaning 200 dots. So again, make sure you also explain how you got that, not just write that down. That here the 100th figure had 301 dots because it had 100 above, 100 to the right, 100 below, and the one in the middle. And that here it had 200 dots because it has 200 columns of two dots each that are vertical from each other. Here we are going to look at writing these in words so that the place value can be identified. So what we have is we have a 4 in the tens place. So what we'd say is 4 tenths. If you said 0 and 4 tenths, that would be fine. Here we have a 1, and then we have a decimal point, which means we say the word and then 3 is in the tens place, so 1 and 3 tenths. Here we have 56, and the last digit is in the hundredths place. We always look at where the last digit lands to look at place value behind the decimal point. So 56, and the last digit's in the hundredths place, so 56 hundredths. Here we have 2 and for the decimal point, and then the 8 is in the thousandths place, so 2 and 8 thousandths. Now they want us to take these words and translate them to decimals. So 35 hundredths means we would need to have 35 behind the decimal point, and the 5 would have to land in the hundredths place, so it would look like this. 3 and 2 tenths means we'd have a 3 in front of the decimal point. The and would be the decimal point. And then 2 tenths means 2 in the tenths place. 6 hundredths means we'd need to have a 6 in the hundredths place, but then that means we'd need to have a 0 in the tenths place as an essential place marker. So the 6 in the hundredths with a 0 in the tenths, we read that as 6 hundredths. Here we need to find the perimeter of each figure. They're telling us that the markings like we see here are indicating that those two lines are parallel. They also talk about the fact that you need to make sure you're showing your work. So for the first one, the perimeter is 22 centimeters. Again, that will not be adequate for work. You need to show that you either took 8 plus 3, got a total of 11, and then doubled it to get 22, or 8 plus 3 plus 8 plus 3 equaling 22 centimeters. Here you should show that you added the 5 plus 3 plus 9 plus 3 to get you an answer of 20 centimeters. Here you'd be adding 13 plus 12 plus 5, getting you 30 inches. 6 plus 3 plus 4, giving you 13 millimeters. These signs here mean congruent. So this would be basically a rhombus. It has all congruent sides. And if each side is 4 feet, then 4 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4, or 4 times 4, is 16 feet. And here, 10 plus 10 plus 5 would give us a perimeter of 25. Then they want us to go back for 122 and to identify what these shapes are called, the best name for them, being as specific as you can. And they remind you that if you're struggling with what any of those words mean or finding a good example of them, you can look in the glossary. So first of all, we can tell that this shape, the best name for it would be a rectangle. It has 4 sides, opposite sides are congruent, angles are 90 degrees. Here we have only one pair of parallel sides. It's a 4-sided figure with only one pair of parallel sides. We call that a trapezoid. Here we have a triangle, but we can see it has a 90 degree angle, so we call that a right triangle. We also could have named that as a scalene triangle because all the side lengths are different from each other. Here, we don't know anything about the angles. We only know about the side measurements. So we can see that it is scalene. Side measurements are not equal to each other. Here, I did already discuss the fact that this would be a rhombus. And again, that's because it's a quadrilateral with all congruent sides, opposite sides being parallel. It does not, however, have 90 degree angles, so it's not a square. And here we have a triangle with 2 congruent sides and the third is different. We call that an isosceles triangle. Remember, you can pause the video at any time to get that down. Here you're going to be using this bar graph to answer these questions. How many people attended the fair on Tuesday? So we're going to find Tuesday down here. We're going to come across. But notice that this is the number of people in thousands. So we have 1, 2, 3, but not 3,000 would be the attendance. And of course we need a label. What day had the largest attendance? Well, that would clearly be Sunday. And then what's the total attendance for the week? Again, I should see the work shown. So I should see that you added 2,000 plus 3,000 plus 5,000 plus 6,000 and so on to get a final answer of 42,000. So make sure you show that work.